Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to ChopBox Studios. I'm your host CJ, and today we're going to be reacting to Boruto episode 192, and we're also going to be doing 193. I don't know if I'm going to upload it in the same video, but we are going to react to it today at the same time. So with that being said, if you guys are new, make sure you leave a like, rate, comment, subscribe below, and become a butcher today for your daily slice of happiness. I'm your host CJ, and we're going to get right into this reaction. Okay, so we got Kawaki. Let me scoot this way so I'm not like in the screen, because I think I am in the screen. He's chopping wood. Got this little bamboo, whatever you call it, container for water. Oh man, he doesn't even hang. Dang. Poor dude. Oh my god, look at that. Look at his eyes. Wow, the art style. The art style is on point. Whoever drew this, thank you. Kudos to you. Art style is amazing. The eyes kind of remind me of, like, Eren from Attack on Titan, kind of, in a way. I don't know. His lips, you can tell that they're chapped. I almost said chopped. Dang, man. And he kind of looks like he's a little beat on the sides. Maybe a little brushed up from being outside, maybe. You know, some work, some labor. I don't know. I want to see where he came from. Like, what kind of village, maybe, or if he even was in a village. What the heck? That reminds me of the freaking, the Akatsuki Tunnel, right? You remember that episode when they found the Akatsuki Temple, and, they found the tunnel, like, the hidden tunnel and everything, and they were having a meeting? That's exactly what this reminds me of, the Akatsuki Tunnel. Oh, look, that looks painted. That's completely different. That is... Oh, that's, like, his boss? Yeah, so he was doing work for somebody. Oh, look at this old guy. Ew, dude. Kawaki is working for somebody. Who, what's his name? Who is he? I don't know. Ew, look at that guy. Oh, but he understands. He understands the struggle. He wants one. Oh, look at this guy. You're my first customer since I got to this village. I'll give you a good deal. Yes, see, I told you, he's gonna freaking get the goldfish. Goldfish symbolize luck, growing abundance with money, and they also repel evil spirits. So this guy is asking about Kawaki and, like, asking if his dad made him get a couple things, asking some personal questions. So I guess he kind of sees what Kawaki's going through, that he's a little beat up and he's interested in a goldfish. So he's trying to really just help out Kawaki and just give him something that he wants for once, because he could see that he's struggling. Outstanding shinobi. Huh. So his dad used to be a good shinobi. So these strangers, and then his dad just spends all the money he makes on booze. Huh. So then what happened to his dad for him to, you know, become a deadbeat like that? So yeah, they're talking about saying that Kawaki's probably not gonna get out of the situation that he's in, and that he's probably stuck there since he's a kid. He's probably just gonna be trapped there for the rest of his life until he's grown. And that's basically what they're saying, trapped like a goldfish in a bucket, which sucks, man. You hear the freaking guitar in the back, got a little strumming in the back. Okay, so he's back home. So that is his dad. Dang, man. Dang. So yeah, my guess was right. His dad is abusive by the way he's talking to him. I mean, you don't really talk to kids like that. And you can see the fear in Kawaki. How gentle he is, how awkward he is, how his face is frowning. You can tell that he's definitely going through some stuff, and that his dad is more on the abusive side.
Okay.
Dang, man. Making a kid buy freaking alcohol? What the heck? Freaking treating him like a freaking... like a slave or something, man. Oh no. Oh no, dude. He found the freaking red ticket that the man gave him. Something bad's gonna happen. I'm just gonna say that. Something bad is probably gonna happen. Man, dang. It's not even that serious, dude. It's a freaking... wow. It's just a freaking fishing thing. Like, it's... wow. Wow. For not listening to me. Aw, oh, that's messed up. Come on, man. And you don't get dinner? That's... nah, that's over the top, bro. You can shred up a stupid ticket, and that doesn't matter because it was free, and it's just a piece of freaking paper. But freaking not letting your kid eat, that's kind of freaking... that's just over the top. That's messed up, man. Dang. Man, what a douchebag. There's the old man again, so he's the one that's selling the liquor. That's what it is. Liquor store. See, it says it right there. How could I be so blind? Selling liquor to kids, man? Crazy. Baldy too. Dang. So there's a sickness going around, apparently a plague that's going around. I wonder if that's gonna tie into the story later in this episode, but we don't know. We'll see. Aw, man, so he's got some freaking bullies too? Dang. Dang, man. Dang, he's in denial too, bro. I mean, we don't know if it's true that he's a shinobi or that his dad's a shinobi because we haven't been shown it. So we can't say for sure if it's true. Maybe it's a lie. Maybe he's just saying that so people think that. Or maybe it is true and he just became a deadbeat somehow. Don't know. Dang, man. Punched him right in the freaking head. Hey, there's my mans. That guy's cool. Yeah, I like that guy. That guy's cool. How could she tell? Like, could she just tell because of the blood? The type of blood he has or something? Or, I don't know. Like, how could they tell that he's actually supposed to be the chosen one or the vessel? Like, how are you supposed to know? Dang, man, he's gonna get freaking... he's gonna get beat. At that point, you can't even go home, and he probably did. Oh, no. Oh, no. I don't want to freaking see this, but it's probably gonna be pretty tough. I feel bad for Kawaki. I mean, like... dang, man, they really put the feels on this episode. This is insane. It's a really good episode, though, for, like, a filler type of thing. So good. Dang, man, why? Oh, my God, man. Really? You're gonna lock him in a freaking cellar or something? Like, what the heck is your problem, dude? What a douchebag, bro. Dude, like, I can't stand that, though. Like, seriously, you're gonna freaking be pissed because your son can't bring you alcohol? Maybe you should get off your ass and go freaking get a job and then freaking come home and support your child like you're supposed to do. I don't know, this freaking episode triggers me right now. Dang, really? Just like that? Man, that's messed up. Bruh, no. Over the top. Okay? This man's is a freaking asshole. I'm not gonna censor that because it's true for the character. I'm not taking it literally, I know, but I'm talking inside of the anime. Dang, man. Dang, did he really hit him with a freaking bottle like that? Wow. That's messed up, bro. Really hit your own son over the head with a bottle, and then you're freaking smiling. Oh my god, bro. That's so messed up, bro. He's calling his own son worthless and a piece of garbage. Like, he's nothing. Like, he's just dirt on the bottom of his shoe. Like, dang, man. And then he freaking broke a bottle over his own son's head? Wow. Really sold his kid for money, man. What a freaking ass. Oh my god. Oh, look at this animation. It's completely different. Jeez. Oh my gosh. The animation, though. Like, it's completely different, the art style. Look at this. There's Jigen. Oh my god. Just look at his face. Like, look at this art style. Look at the sunken in eyes. The freaking shadowing. It's like painted. It's not drawn. It's painted. Oh my god. Look at his chapped lips. Oh man. So that's when they took him to the facility and tested on him or did whatever they did. We don't know for sure yet because we haven't seen the full backstory quite yet. Maybe we get the rest in this episode, but we'll see. Look at that. Doesn't that look like a freaking Akatsuki tunnel, bro? And he walked past that before. It was difficult to find. I feel so bad for Kawaki. He's just being tossed around like some freaking object, man. I mean, at least Jigen's not, like, super violent because he's intelligent and actually knows not to freaking hurt somebody or not to freaking fight somebody or freaking kill somebody for no reason. He just knows what to do. Wait, who is that? Who is that? Oh, that's the guy. Oh, he's gonna die. Oh, God. He's gonna die. He's gonna die. He's gonna die. He's gonna die. This man doesn't know that Jigen is just not human, and so he's probably gonna get obliterated and killed right in front of Kawaki, and that's the only man that cared for Kawaki. And he thinks that Jigen is just a trafficker. I can't blame him because he doesn't know, obviously, but I can tell you right now he's probably going to get killed. Dang, man. I don't want him to die. He was such a cool guy. Wait. Oh, wait, no, he's bad? Whoa. Huh? Oh, never mind. I take back what I said. I retract all my statements. Never mind, I think he should be killed. Never mind. I hope Jigen does kill him. Like, hey, you're a freaking scum. Why is he seeing a bunch of fish, though? It's weird. But he's done. He's dead. That guy's dead. The intensity. He gladly withdrew. What the heck? Is a bad thing. That's not the case at all. Oh, so he's saying you think that being empty and hollow is a bad thing, but he's saying that that's not the case at all. Oh my god. The freaking music, the freaking Kara music. What the heck? Are those all? Those are all children? Are those really all children in those freaking bag things? What the heck? Nothing to be afraid of. You are now one of my precious children. I don't know about that one. Oh my god, look at that freaking style. It's so freaking, like, eerie. You'll no longer be hollow. Oh my god, so is this how he got, like, his powers or his karma seal or whatever? It seems to me that they're incubating or doing some sort of, like, method where they take a bunch of kids and they put them in this capsule and they turn them into something. Oh, and then he woke up. Okay, we're back to present time. We're back to present time. There's Naruto, the boy. There we go. Yes, sir. Alright, that was a good episode. Of course, it didn't have fighting, but that doesn't matter. Because, you see, I usually don't like filler. But if it's good filler like this, where it actually has a story that I care about, and the animation is pretty good, the story is awesome, then, yeah, I love it. But if it's just some BS, like, oh, it's Father's Day, I don't really care for it, you know? Overall, I would have to give this episode a 9 out of 10 as well. Super nice, super cool. We got a nice backstory on Kawaki. We finally understand his past, so we can see why he's so skeptical about different people and different subjects. With that said, if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a like, rate, comment, subscribe below, and become a butcher today for your daily slice of happiness. I'm your host CJ, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.